¿Por qué muere aquí? Tío Tian.
I wouldn't have thought I'd meet you here. You were always so terribly busy.
This old man called her Little Miss Ganyu.
Allow me to introduce Uncle Tian. He is...
That's all right. Just tell them the truth. They have done so much for Leo after all, and I am the one who has yet to introduce myself.
Uncle Tian is a member of the Leo of Chisin, the Tianshu.
What? Ay, mierda.
Grandpa is a member of the Chisin? The same rank as Ningguang?
Hush now. I must ask for your discretion concerning my identity. Fishing in the port and strolling about are the greatest pleasures of my life. I have no wish to be followed around by those armed guys. In most people's eyes, I'm just a forgetful and wordy old man.
Uncle Tian is too modest. He's been around for a long time. There's no one who can replace a person of such noble character.
Estoy intentando recordar si no me lo hice enojar.
Oh, little Miss Ganyu. Your kind words make me feel that my decades of hard work haven't been in vain.
Uncle Tian. A person of your standing should really stop calling me Little Miss Ganyu.
No, oh, my apologies. It's not intentional, just a childhood habit of mine. Thank you for looking after me when I first ascended to my position in the Cheese Sing.
Oh, so you've been friends for many decades now, huh?
Oh, I was just fulfilling my duties as the Cheese Sing secretary. It's nothing worthy of your gratitude.
Talking about secretaries, I don't know if I should bring it up. Ganyu, I believe you know my daughter, Hui Xin. She seems to be a bit troubled recently.
Yes, she works at Yuehai Pavilion and she's my junior. How can I help her?
I don't know myself, really. She's all grown up now and doesn't like to ask for my help. May I trouble you to meet her at UAI Pavilion? She just needs a bit of guidance.
With pleasure. Solving the Chi-Sing's problems has always been in my job description.
She's back in character, just like that, huh?
Sí, como era de esperar de las 7 estrellas, en realidad está ayudándola. Creo que Kanye no se dio cuenta de lo que está pasando. Más o menos.
Indeed, it has been a while, Hui Xin. I'm flattered, but aren't you exaggerating a little? I heard that you've encountered.
Bienvenido al que va llegando.
And came to see if I could be of some help.
My father asked you to come, didn't he?
Sí.
Using his status as a member of the Chi Sing to trouble you.
Don't worry. I'm always happy to help a junior colleague from the High Pavilion.
Hmm.
A competent secretary, but also a great mentor.
Yes.
So,
yes.
What can you tell me about the problem?
Ugh, where should I start?
Tú dime y ahorita lo reparamos.
There are obvious irregularities in the tax declarations of two stores, Second Life and Wanyo Boutique. However, whether I question the shopkeepers or check their accounts, I can't seem to make any progress with my investigation. Without any evidence, my hands are tied.
I see. It's not uncommon for merchants to be blinded by greed.
Well, is there any solution you can advise?
Naturally. I've dealt with similar issues hundreds of times. Give me a moment to consider the best approach in this scenario.
LOL, debe tener como 1000 años de experiencia en tu trabajo. LOL, esa Paimuk. Bienvenido al que acaba de llegar.
Your enemy knows you best. Huh? If I remember correctly, Second Life and Wanyo Boutique are old business rivals, competing for market share due to their similar wares.
Es que compitan o algo así.
In that case, I know what you mean, Miss Gunn.
Ya que compitan y que uno de los dos le dices que a los dos prácticamente el que te entregue algo, no sé, le vas a dar algún beneficio o algo y vas a ver cómo los dos te entregan su cuenta real. Que sí, exactamente, que se delaten entre sí.
Exactly. Let's start with Wanyo Boutique. The owner's name is
Voila.
Yes, you're right. Follow me, please.
Aha, we meet again, traveler. And you must be from the Yuhai Pavilion. I suppose you're about to place a big order. I'd be honored to offer you my wares.
That won't be necessary, Mr. Bolai. Wanyo Boutique's credit is not sufficient to accept orders directly from Yuhai Pavilion. Should we need to place such an order, we would certainly go to Second Life instead.
What? Second Life? Ugh. That rascal Dong Shun. He's stealing all of my customers.
Well, Second Life's credit has always been excellent, and based on their tax records, their business is thriving.
Tax records? Thriving?
Huh. Is there anything you'd like to share with us, Mr. Bolai?
Don't let that rascal fool you. I know his dirty tricks best. If you don't believe me, show me his tax records. I'm sure I'll find something fishy in there.
You know Second Life's business so well?
Of course. Ugh, their every transaction makes my blood boil. I'd rather lose money myself than see that rascal make some.
¿Qué te callas?
Please look over this tax record. We'll review Second Life's credit based on your observations.
Oh, of course. I'll read very, very carefully. Line by line and word by word. Ah, here I found it. That exquisite wooden furniture set he bought from Fanmu Carpenters at the beginning of the year. Ugh, he even flaunted it in front of me. Look at the tax record. Not a word about that furniture. And he kept all the profit for himself.
Sí.
I see. He must have gotten rid of all the documents related to this transaction. No wonder there was no trace of it.
I told you so. Just as I expected.
Y la cara que vas a poner tú ahora que te, cuando él te diga.
Miss Ganyu, despite all this, can't he just flat out deny ever making this transaction? He might have destroyed all the evidence, but I believe the supplier, Fanmu Carpenters, might still have some proof of it.
Yep.
Aha, you're right. Master Lu from Fanmu Carpenters must still have the invoice. He wouldn't be swayed by the likes of Dongshan.
I hope so. Let's go to Fanmu Carpenters. It should be near Qingxia Village. Thank you for shining a light on this case, Mr. Balai.
Oh, please, please, that's nothing. I just hope you won't be lenient with him once you find the evidence. That's the best way to show your gratitude.
I'm afraid I can't go to Qingxia Village.
It's all right, Weixin. You could stay in Liyue Harbor and finish your work.
Yep.
Leave the rest to us.
Oh, that's so considerate of you. Still, I'm sorry to trouble you like that.
Ah, nuestro amigo. Después de tanto tiempo.
Welcome, welcome. carpenter like me help you? I am usually happy to take new apprentices, but I'm afraid I can't take too many at once. But I'm always around if you're keen for a chat.
Kingsa really is full of lonely old people.
Hey, I heard that, flying one.
Sorry.
Master Lu, we've just come to see you and ask you some questions.
Ah, don't worry, I know. You're from the Yuhai Pavilion, right? Why would the Chi-Sing care about an old man like me? Well, whatever. You said that you want to ask me something. Ask away, then.
You're very direct, Master Lu. I will be plain. We're looking for proof that Dongshen from Second Life has been evading taxes. Dongshen bought some furniture from you at the beginning of the year. Do you still have the invoice or any other record of that transaction?
Oh, it's about Second Life. It was a big order. How could I forget?
Sure enough, Mr. Balai was right. Could we perhaps borrow that invoice? We won't have any evidence to bring against Dongshen otherwise.
Of course you can. But I'm not so sprightly.
¿Por qué?
What's that supposed to mean?
I only do my woodwork and display finished wares here, at Fanmu Carpenters. As for old documents and such, I keep them all in a warehouse, west of here. But some troublemakers have recently moved there, invading my warehouse. I tried to drive them away, but they just wouldn't leave. Since you need that invoice anyway, it may be best to get it from the warehouse yourself. And while you're at it, you can teach those
convenientes para ponernos a trabajar. Conveniente.
So that's what happened. I see.
I'll leave you to it then. I need to get back to work.
Vale.
Wait, I think I saw one of those troublemakers. Ah, over there.
Oh, Paimon season 2. It's one of the Fatui.
They must be plotting something against Liyue Harbor.
Maybe they're the scoundrels who invaded Master Lu's warehouse.
Ever since Osile attacked the harbor, the Fatui's reputation in Liyue has reached rock bottom. We won't cause a serious diplomatic crisis by getting into some small scuffle with the Fatui within our borders. You need not worry. Besides, I can already feel their malicious intentions. Consider it my intuition as the secretary of the Chi-Sing.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go teach him a lesson.
Yay! Ah, qué chill, me la quitaron. Sí, sabandija, que te partieron la cara.
About time you tell us your plan. No?
Plan? What plan?
We just taught you a lesson, but clearly you weren't paying attention. If you don't spill whatever you're scheming against Liyue, we'll be forced to use harsher methods.
¿Qué fuimos? Vamos, confiesa.
I'm telling the truth. There's no scheme.
If you're telling the truth, then why would you, a member of the Fatui, suddenly appear on the outskirts of Qingxia Village?
Fine. If you really want to know, then, well, I was about to.
About to what?
Berries over there.
I must admit, I didn't expect you to come up with such a silly excuse.
It's not an excuse. I rarely have a free morning, and I heard that there were fresh berries in this area. Think about it. I'm here alone, and Qingxia Village is nothing more than a retirement spot for old people. What could I be scheming anyway?
Joder, a los
ancianos. Judging by how he's looking at us, it does seem like he feels like he's the victim here.
So you have nothing to do with the occupation of Fanmu Carpenter's warehouse?
Fanmu Carpenter's warehouse? Where's that? I swear, I only came here to pick berries, that's all.
So it wasn't the Fatui who took over Master Lu's warehouse after all.
I also feel that he's telling the truth.
No creo, pero bueno.
Whoopsie!
Puede ser, no todos los Fatui tienen que por qué ser malos.
My apologies. Our exchange only represents my personal views. If you wish it so, you can file a complaint to the Ministry of Civil Affairs.
Exchange? This woman, she's clearly aware that the Ministry of Civil Affairs wouldn't side with us Fatui.
Yes, precisely. As an alternative, you may try to solve this problem with force once again.
Vamos a punto.
Darn you. How could you wear that solemn face while bullying me like this?
What's your choice then?
I'll get back to my berries.
Panele jump.
What a bittersweet ending.
I made a laughing stock out of myself. I might have spent too much time away from work. My intuition is not as accurate as it used to be.
No worries. It's always nice to teach the Fatui a lesson.
Let's keep moving towards Master Lu's warehouse. Our goal is to get the invoice after.
Mm-hmm. Ah, son estos peludos los que están cubriendo ya. Vale, fuera. Se les acabó la suerte. Se les acabó la suerte.
This one is an invoice from One Min Restaurant. Some dining tables and chairs. That's not it. This one is Wong Xiong Funeral Parlors.
No sabes que sean ataúdes, es una funeraria, pedacito de gente. ¿Y la otra? Hey, ¿y la otra? Acá.
From the UI pavilion. I remember you.
¿No será que también nos estafa a nosotros de vez en cuando?
Transactions are included in the records. My tax declarations are scrupulous as well. I do hope that my business won't be affected by any groundless accusations.
Groundless accusations? Mr. Dongsheng, you seem very sure of yourself. But I sincerely advise that you cease this behavior immediately. It is liable to affect the fine you'll need to pay in the end.
No. I'm an honest merchant. I would never get involved with any fraudulent sources of profit.
Ya no estás seguro de mí mismo, que sinvergüenza.
Haven't I made myself clear? Mr. Dongsheng, you've already been proven guilty of tax evasion. I just came here to see if you'd confess.
What? Proven guilty? How come? That's impossible. Absolutely absurd.
Talking without rhyme or reason must be crumbling under Ganyu's pressure.
Time
for the finishing blow!
Mr. Dongsheng, can you tell me what this is?
It's an invoice from Fan Mu Carpenters.
Uy, te agarraron de los huevos.
I'm Master Lu. I didn't.
Do you admit to tax evasion? This transaction was absent from the tax record.
I didn't think you'd find out. I didn't leave a single trace.
Indeed. We wouldn't have found out if it weren't for Mr. Bolai's aid.
Bolai? That imp from Wanyo Boutique? So he told on me behind my back. He's got his own share of dirty laundry.
Mr. Dongsheng, I'd like to hear a little more about this dirty laundry. Would you care to elaborate? I don't think you'll need my guidance for what comes next.
Yes, thank you, Ms. Ganyu. I can take it from here.
That's good.
I must say, you're truly impressive, Ms. Ganyu. Your enemy knows you best. To think, you came up with this plan and executed it so masterfully.
It's actually one of your father's, the Tianxu's, old tricks. I just took some inspiration from it.
My father?
Yep.
Hitting your opponent against their enemies, and watching them drag each other down from an advantageous position, that's how Uncle Tian managed to keep his position in the Qixing secure for so many years. I figured that as Uncle Tian's daughter, you'd naturally grasp your father's strategies. So, I decided to use one of your father's tricks and play it out for you to see.
I can see it now. Clearly, I still have
todos tenemos que aprender, por cierto, bienvenido al que acaba de llegar. Todos tenemos que aprender de nuestros padres en algún momento. Eso es más que obvio.
You've helped me so much. You must allow me to repay your kindness.
That's not necessary. No need to be so serious. It was nothing, really.
Then let me treat you to a meal. The traveler and Paimon are invited as well. I appreciate
it. Sí, le hablaste de comida, le diste en su mate a la pobre Paimon. No seas maleducada.
Actually, I've already booked Señor Kias. I need a moment to prepare everything first. Let's meet there in a while.
Hmm. All right. We dare not refuse such generosity.
La coco cabra, la coco cabra. Aquí llegó la coco cabra, la coco cabra. Hola, coco cabra. Ah, carajo, se activó.
Miss Ganyu, thank you for accepting my invitation. And as for the two of you, your presence is also much appreciated.
That's so kind of you, Huixin. You went to great lengths to organize this.
Vale.
Truth be told, apart from thanking you for all the help, there's something I'd like to tell you.
Mm.
Oh? If there's anything I can help you with, just tell me straight away. No need to hesitate.
Oh, no, I don't really need help. Could you just listen for a bit?
With pleasure.
When I was a little girl, my father used to tell me many stories about you, Miss Ganyu. Even though I had the utmost respect for my father, I always admired how gentle and reliable
you are. Hay gente que es así.
I decided to join the Yuhai Pavilion staff because I've always looked up to you.
I didn't know that you think so highly of me.
However, in reality, working at the Yuhai Pavilion turned out to be an arduous task. I can't compare myself to such an outstanding secretary like you. I often doubt myself as a result.
I disagree. You're a great secretary in your own right.
Thank you. Over the years, I became a mother, too.
So Uncle Tian is a grandpa!
Influenced by my youthful ideals, she followed my footsteps and came to be a secretary at the Yuhai Pavilion too. At first, I was worried about her. It's not an easy job, after all. To tell the truth, I'm...
Pero ese es el primer error que cometes como padre. Creer que tu hijo no puede.
This time, I made up my mind to support her choice.
So, what made you change your mind?
The fact that she'll have you, Ms. Ganyu. As her senior colleague, you'll help her, gentle as always, and tell her your mom used to do it like that.
Mm.
It'd be such a beautiful moment. If it's not too much to ask for, she might still need your guidance in 20-plus years, too.
Huixin, I never thought that I meant so much to you.
Pero sí, significas mucho para su familia.
It's like when you showed me my father's trick. Having you as their witness makes people feel at ease.
Witness. It's true that I've witnessed thousands of years of Liyue Harbor's history. All the changes it's gone through. The stories of its people. but I've always regarded it as nothing more than the source of my loneliness. Huixin, you don't know how important those words are to me. You've made me realize that I share another connection with the people of Liyue Harbor. Apart from my contract with Rex Lapis, they rely on me, accept me, and long for me to bear witness to them.
Claro, ¿quién no querría que alguien que vive por muchos años pudiera contar historias sobre él? Creo que cualquier hombre sobre la tierra querría ser recordado. Y recordado por siempre por familiares, amigos y personas de todo el mundo. Ya te dije que nadie te ha hecho. Sí. Mentira.
So kind of you all. Given we've only met once. We've been praying day and night for you to return and take over your duties again. To us, you're like an adeptus coming down to the human world to save all life. Forget all our envious complaints from before. Just free us from this strenuous work, please. Alright. Alright, I see. Please divide the matters at hand into government affairs, business affairs, and civil affairs. Mark out the tasks that haven't been started, and those that are in progress. I'll take care of the rest.
Of course. We'll do it right away. Oh, finally. We're saved.
Yes. There's one more thing. I'd like to earnestly thank you, Traveler. If it weren't for your companionship, I would still be embroiled in my inner conflict right now. To think that I'd gained a human friend outside of work. It makes me happier than I could have imagined. I'd like to repay you when I'm done with the work at hand. What would you say if I...
Claro, por supuesto.
...you on one of your trips?
Sure, but are you ever done with work on you?
Let's cross that bridge when we come to it, shall we?
Vale, pues hasta ahí queda. Mar de nubes, mar de humanos. Sí, mitad humano, mitad de tus. Ah, mire, subimos de nivel, genial. Bueno, gente, ahí termina la misión de Ganyu. Creo que eso ha sido todo, espero les haya gustado el capítulo de Ganyu. Yo soy Vir, me despido y nos vemos hasta la próxima en el video donde saquemos el gachapón de Ganyu. De Ganyu, de Ganyu. Nos vemos hasta la próxima. Cuídense. Bye.